Bird flu has been around for many years, but recent outbreaks have raised concerns that it could spread to humans and impact our economy. Since 2022, H5N1 has infected more than 90 million chickens, 9,000 wild birds, 34 dairy herds, and cattle in 9 states. Officials are calling it an animal pandemic that could spread to humans. I'm Mia DeGraff. I'm a health editor at Business Insider, and today we're going to be talking about bird flu. Bird flu is a virus. The type we're talking about today is called H5N1. This highly contagious form of bird flu, which is known as 2344B, first emerged in 2020. It was seen in birds in Europe, Africa, and Asia. In 2021, it was detected in North America. This bird flu is different from previous strains in a few ways. It's more lethal. We're seeing unusually high rates of death. For example, among chickens, a 90% death rate. What's been alarming about this outbreak is that we've seen it move from mammal to mammal. There's a lot of migration going on right now, and that's quite unusual. We've seen it in cows. We've seen it in domestic cats, domestic dogs. We've also seen it in foxes and sea lions, and we've seen it in humans. One person in Colorado who was in close contact with poultry that was being culled, and then one farm worker in Texas who was in close contact with a cow who was infected. We haven't yet seen human-to-human transmission, but those kinds of interactions, that is cause for concern. Sometimes this virus doesn't have very clear symptoms. You might just be a little groggy. It's kind of the same as a flu. You might have muscle aches, you might have a headache, but it can range. The cost of this is huge. The US government has a pretty blunt approach to trying to curtail this outbreak. Basically, they pay farms to proactively kill all of its chicken, turkey, any poultry that may have been exposed to bird flu. In 2023, the US government paid farms $500 million for the animals that they killed, proactively preventing bird flu. Bird flu outbreaks definitely drive up the price of grocery store items. The reason being that you suddenly have a scarcity of product due to culls, but the demand hasn't changed. So you might have seen in recent years that sometimes, independent of inflation, there'll be these fluctuations in the price of, say, eggs. You might get your normal carton of eggs that would cost $3 is suddenly costing $7. The 2022 bird flu outbreak cost the US poultry industry around $3 billion. The way bird flu is contracted is really through close contact with an infected animal. If you're worried about contracting bird flu, definitely do not consume raw milk. Anything that's unpasteurized, it's risky at the best of times, but right now it's really not something you want to do. Generally, the FDA says that pasteurized products are safe, but if you are concerned about it, just make sure you're cooking things extra good. The best way to stay safe as farm workers is really to have protective gear, so goggles, masks, gloves, things that will protect them from coming into contact with infected bodily fluids, respiratory droplets, feces, anything like that. If these workers are given the right protection and also the right training, they could actually play a really crucial role in helping us to detect and curtail the spread of this virus. It's higher stakes than before, for sure. There are more countries involved, there are more species involved, there are more opportunities for this virus to mutate and spread. But the one thing I can say about flu is that it is really surprising, sometimes in positive ways. So we've been monitoring this H5N1 for years. In 1997, H5N1 was seen in humans for the first time in workers in Hong Kong, and everyone thought that this was then going to become the big pandemic. It was actually the leading candidate ahead of a coronavirus for what we thought would be a global pandemic, but that wasn't the case. Flu is often a sort of right place, right time kind of thing where it could bubble up into a huge outbreak. This has been in the right place at the right time so many times, and it still hasn't got there. So scientists are saying that is some cause for optimism. The fact that this hasn't exploded, maybe suggest that it's not going to get there. The other thing, though, is that it does show us how little we really know about flu. We keep thinking that we understand where it's going to go, and then it doesn't go that way. People at home don't need to panic about bird flu right now. But this is certainly a rapidly evolving situation that the government and scientists are monitoring closely.